Mr. Happy Living here, and I'm happy to be broadcasting from WITV7 in the beautiful Queen City, Charlotte, North Carolina, USA. Hey friends, please join me for just a minute and imagine how amazing you'd feel living the unique and distinct life you were put on this planet to live, doing work you love, with people you love, in places you love, and all the while creating something of real value to others. Well, that's what I call a life of significance. And I can tell you, it makes for a very happy life. And so can Arnaud St. Paul. He's my guest star today, and he's here to share his unique and distinct journey to his life of significance. But before I bring him on, I want to share a poem we created to thank him for being our guest star today. It's called A Journey of Heart and Mind, and it goes like this. Open your heart and let your mind rest. A billion souls he seeks to bless. Arnaud leads with love and light through every challenge, both day and night. His journey began at age 13, a quest for purpose, deep and keen. With wisdom gained and lessons learned, he shows the world how hearts are bared. I'm sorry, with wisdom gained and lessons shared, he shows the world how hearts are bared. From Paris to LA, Arnaud does roam, building his global heart-centered home. Join in as our minds and hearts align on this show of significance where purpose does shine. Hey, Arnaud, welcome to the show.
Yay, that's beautiful. Thank you. It's a beautiful poem. I usually write them, not receiving one, so thank you.
You're quite welcome. So get us started by telling us what you're doing these days to make your mark of significance on the world.
Oh, well, it's rather simple. As you said in the poem, my life purpose to help 1 billion people to open their heart to themselves. And the vehicle to that is a movement called the Heart Economy, bringing leaders together to practice heart leadership and lead through their heart instead of their mind. And so I also have a Heart Leadership Institute called Tapuat. And together we're, you know, building a world that is lived through the heart.
That's beautiful. So describe the definition, or tell us the definition of a conscientious technologist.
Conscious technologist,
yes.
Yeah, that was an old definition, but I guess it's, you know, we are conscious beings, right? So yeah. Anything we are creating is imbued with consciousness anyway. So how can we use technology with consciousness, becoming aware of its impact and so on, but more importantly, using technology to seed humanity with more consciousness, more awareness. So that would be my definition.
Very good. And tell our audience quickly about your Heart Leadership DNA quiz. I took it. It was pretty interesting. So just tell them what it is and how it works and why they should take it.
Okay. So that's a test I created a year ago, which is amazingly accurate. Not because I created it. It's just, you know, the result still surprised me. And so in heart leadership, we have 7 pillars: presence, inner peace, inner joy, non-attachment, dharma, unity and selflessness. And so you have the opportunity by answering 35 questions really quickly to assess yourself related to these 7 pillars and see where you stand on that journey. So this way we are able to showcase or to show where you stand on that journey towards more heart.
Yeah.
And it's really awesome. Yeah. Why taking it? I mean, if you feel resonating with this idea of leading your life through your heart or your company for that matter, well, it completely makes sense because it will show you how coherent and how much cohesion you have within yourself.
Yeah.
The scoring is really accurate in that sense. And the less coherence, the more difficulty, the more struggle, the more difficult life we have, right? And the more coherence, the more cohesion, the more harmony, life is magical. It's amazing, right?
Yes, so, sir. You know, I love doing my research on you because there's so much areas in which we align. And I have an 8-week e-course, and the tagline for it kind of is, in 8 weeks, we can move you 15 inches out of your head and into your heart.
Yeah.
And it's really, that's when you're living there, Man, it's magical, as you just said. Okay, two more things, if you can, quickly in this section. Tell us about, I think you've written two books, The Human Project, and is it titled I Is
Yeah.
Born?
Yes, correct.
That's an unusual title. So give us a 30 seconds or a minute on both of those and why our listeners should go and read them.
Well, the first one is rather peculiar. It was really my first intent writing something, and it came out like in a month. It's a short story of how we are. So this the story of two angels creating the human experience. So the human project is really the project of a humanity, Earth, and whatnot, but from a Earth, from an angel viewpoint. So it's something that did not exist so far. So I was very happy creating that. And really, it was more of a channel than anything else. The second one is a bit more serious, between quotes, and then also not. It's the dialogue between I, because that I that we all repeat all the time is actually consciousness, right? Where I'm living through that I, and self. Self is that infinite aspect of ourselves. We can call it divine, anything, doesn't really matter. What matters is that pure and conditional love that is within us has that dialogue with I. And so these 66 poems are here to illustrate a new viewpoint. So first we define, we redefine words like new, like assertiveness, like etc. Words that were helping me on my own path, and but from the viewpoint of self, of that divine aspect. And then it's more of a dialogue between both, exploring this, offering this viewpoint of the loving aspect of ourselves that is waiting for I to be born or for I to blossom, right? And so it could be, it's a bit like Rumi, but in very different way as well. So, I mean, it's an amazing book. And it's very useful for the work we're doing, actually.
Awesome. Very good. All right, Arnaud, let's do a little mathematics so our friends all around the world can get to know you through our happy formula. It's simple, but it's really powerful. It goes like this: power plus purpose equals happy. So let's start with power. What are your personal practices for building up all the power you need to get things done, whether it's physically, mentally, financially, spiritually, emotionally? In other words, Arnaud, what do you do on a regular basis to create all the power you need, take really good care of yourself and your loved ones, and still have plenty left over so you can be a giver to others?
That's a big program. I wouldn't define it as power, but I'll play the game anyway. First
and
habit.
Let me stop you. I started off with that as capacity. Does that resonate better?
No.
Okay, but play the game.
It's okay.
Play the
it's
game.
Okay.
Yeah, but play the game and also tell us what your take is, because I'm interested in that.
Okay. So first habit is meditation every day for about an hour. Second is walking, whenever I'm in the mountains, more so. Third is, practicing my method, the Heartful Method, which is a method that uses life as a tool to help us release anything that is hampering our growth. And I think this is my biggest power, and the one that I'm using to help others as well on their own path. So to help them understand that life is a vibration, and therefore, when we learn to read it and to understand it, it becomes an amazing tool to let go of anything that is limiting us. And therefore, we live more in our heart. Yes?
It's okay, so lately, about a year ago, I stumbled into this idea that when I was talking about my capacities or my powers, that there's a difference between earthly power, financial, physical, mental, and spiritual power. Earthly power is finite. You use it, you have to replenish it. Spiritual power is infinite. The more you use it, the more you have of it. So talk a little bit about that, because I think that's what you're describing when you said that's your most powerful source.
Yeah, it's very interesting. Actually, from my viewpoint, they are both the same. They are both infinite. But it starts always from what you call the spiritual power. The moment you start living life, every single moment, every single discussion, situation, challenge, whatever, from that spiritual viewpoint, you start opening up a box of amazing different meanings that lead you to the place where a pattern that is, has been showing through these challenges and whatnot can be released. And when that happens, therefore, the financial, the health, the whatever you are saying, the more material powers arise and come to you or manifest better for you. So for me, the seed is in what you call the spiritual power, which is very, very, very much grounded into the pragmatic and practical approach to life as it is. Not as we want it to be, not as we project it to be, but more as what is happening now.
So,
and that's the beauty of that, of that method that we have.
There's one of my favorite quotes that says, when my gratitude is higher than my expectations, those are really good days. And that's kind of what you're talking about. It's not what you want, it's what is.
Definitely what is. Your heart is always leading you in a perfect way. The question is, why is it that way? And then from then on, there is a work that can be done.
Yeah, and the question I think also is, if we resist that, then we create turmoil, inner turmoil, maybe outer turmoil also. But if you just go with it, it leads you maybe not where you thought you were going, but where you're supposed to be. Yeah,
exactly.
Very good. I think, my friend, you and I could talk a very long time, but we're going to have to move along here. Let's discuss my favorite power generating concept. I call it a Kaizen state of mind. And it's this beautiful Japanese idea that small incremental improvements add up over time to yield great big results. And I love it, Arnaud, because it's based on mindset, not circumstance. Kaizen in life is knowing there's always something I can do better tomorrow than today. And for me, it creates an optimistic, gentle, but very powerful and continuous uplifting of my life day after day after day. So Arnaud, how does Kaizen in your life help you increase your power to continuously become more so you can continuously give more?
I will come back to exactly the same thing. The more I live life, the more opportunity I have to be myself more. And as I do that, I am able to release deeper and deeper things that are coming from, you know, now by then. And therefore, I am happier, more joyful, more at peace, et cetera, et cetera. So it's, for me, it's the way of living. To live through your heart is really to be highly pragmatic and practical, and at the same time, releasing anything that I can become aware of. And the more I do that, the happier I am, and everyone around me.
Yeah, I think what you said is the more you practice and you become closer to where your heart is. Now you've done the work today. When you wake up tomorrow, you're starting already from that advanced place, and you're able to get more and more. And that you can build a car that way, or you can build a heart-centered life that way.
Exactly.
That's what Kaizen is.
And it is instantaneous. You don't have to wake up the next morning. It happens right away.
Yes.
That's the beauty of it.
Yeah. Very good. All right, let's explore purpose. That's the second element of our happy formula. And Arnaud, I've observed that major life transformations, those really big discoveries of purpose, often, sadly, come from devastation. Addiction, abuse, disease, death, disaster, something awful strips a life to its core, resulting in a big and often unexpected change. However, in my book, Turning Inspiration into Action, I share a transformational process that I've used to discover purpose of my life using inspiration. So how about you, Arnaud? Is there a specific moment or event or crisis or inspiration that revealed to you the God-given purpose you were meant to live?
Yes and no. I would say there are no events that happened throughout my life that triggered me into a higher understanding of life. It happened in stages. However, there was a seminal moment at the very beginning of my life, at my birth, that was indeed difficult for me, for my mother, etc., which created a pattern that was needed in order for me to have these Eureka moments at 13, for instance, or in my 40s when I realized that my life purpose is to help 1 billion people to open their heart to themselves. So I would say both yes and no, hence the answer.
Yeah. So will you tell us what that birth situation was?
Very simply, I was supposed to go the natural way, and it happened that it was not the case, and nothing was, we were not in a hospital at the time, but in a clinic, nothing was available for a C-section. Back, went to the hospital, but in the process, my mother had an aneurysm, and so I was not with her for the first month of my life either, which has created a certain consciousness, I guess, that would allow me to open to a certain, to keep a certain consciousness that I would start to arise in my day-to-day life when I was 13.
You said that your mother was, you couldn't be with her because she was where?
She was in ICU for a month.
In ICU, okay. Okay. Huh. That's very interesting. And then what happened, what was 13 all about? What happened at 13?
13 was the realization at the time that God was everywhere for me. So it's, in other words, finding my own truth, whatever was saying the around, you know, what the school was saying or my parents, for me, God was within and also in the trees around me and whatnot. So, and that was the start of, you know, then I became obsessed on how can I live my life from my heart.
So to tell our audience, try to explain to us what happened. Was it a eureka moment? Some feeling overcame you? How did you feel and how did you change from one day to the next?
I guess what I remember is that, so when school and my parents were imposing on me their vision of the world, and all of a sudden for me, no, it's not that, it's something else. So there's a realization of that. And out of that started to come other thoughts that were, you know, or understandings that I would start sharing with friends and whatnot. And that helped a few people around. But more importantly, it's led me to understand who I am, what is that human experience of sorts, and how can I live from my heart? That was very important for me. And when I was in my early adult years, I went to all the different practices and religions and philosophies and studies, the Upanishad and the Vedas, and, you know, putting my hands on everything and finding truths that I had already thought or felt in these books. So, wow.
Yeah. And then you mentioned 40. There was a big change at 40, and mission for a billion hearts.
Yes. So in other words, I was working in finance and startups, tech startups, and it was more the realization, you know what, all these tech things, I'm tired about it. What is really, really making a difference for me?
Yeah.
Not the money, it's not the tech thing, is to see a heart open. That's the best gift I can give to myself.
Awesome.
So let's have fun.
Yeah.
Help a heart open, and why not 1 billion while I'm at it? Because I worked in finance, in technology, so I could potentially whip up something with that.
I get goosebumps. The so many similarities, I won't go into them all, but also I went through the business life and had a realization to start focusing not on making companies better, but changing people. And in my case, I had exactly the opposite effect. I said, instead of trying to get a billion, I said, look, Matt, if you could just improve the life of one person, that would be worth it. So that became our tagline, improving the happy of the world one person at a time.
So I thought
it was very interesting. We aligned so much, but even that is kind of the polar opposite, but it means the same thing. You expressed it the same way, changing one heart. Yeah.
Yeah, of course. I mean, 1 billion is just for the fun.
Yeah.
It doesn't really matter, per se.
Very good. All right, Arno. Thank you for that. And let's take a quick commercial break so I can spread a little love with our audience. Mr. Happy Living here. I love good things made for good people. That's why I love Happy Living's online e-course. It's an 8-week long deep dive into you and the inspired life you want to live. The life you were put here on this earth to live. The one that you and only you can live. 8 weeks of lectures and ideas and topics and supporting materials and powerful self-improvement tools. All designed for you. All designed to help you create the tools and the power and the confidence you need to discover your purpose and to discover the life you were meant to live and to feel incredibly inspired and motivated to decide you will live your life to its fullest. It's all designed to help you create the unique and distinct philosophy of you and your inspired life. Go to happyliving.com, select our e-course, and save $100 with promo code WYTV7. And for every enrollment, I'll donate another $100 to WYTV7. For $300 and about 30 hours, I promise you'll never, ever be the same again. And we're back, and this is the Something Significant Show, and I'm your host, Matt Gersper, and my special guest star today is Arnaud St. Paul. He's a conscious technologist, an author, an international lecturer who walks the talk when it comes to spiritual entrepreneurship. Through his writings, workshops, and lectures, Arnaud shares his experiences, his inner self-expansion, and his true passion to be and bring more love to the world. While Arnaud, I love your passion statement to just be, and while doing that, to bring more love into the world, just as we strive to do at Happy Living, one person at a time. And I think you're going to love this article that I found called The Science Behind the Power of Giving. It says the act of giving itself can be a gateway for discovering your purpose and your reason for being on this planet. It says that science tells us that giving our time and talents and treasures is a powerful pathway for discovering purpose and overcoming difficulties and finding fulfillment and meaning in life. So I updated our formula. Power plus purpose plus giving equals really happy. So how about you, Arnaud? Has giving your time, talents, and treasures been a pathway for discovering your purpose and for getting past difficulties you've faced and for bringing real meaning into your life?
Yes, I mean, I cannot imagine my life without giving. It doesn't make sense. So I don't know anything else. So yeah, I guess.
Was your life always that way, or was there changes happened?
I've been 40 years looking to live through my heart, so I guess.
A long time. Yeah. All right. Well, that's a short answer, but it aligns with the science that tells us that giving to others brings real meaning to our lives. And the joy that we feel from our fourth element of significance, so the joy from doing it, doing work that creates value for others, confirms the science. But there's something more to it than just the giving, Arnaud. I believe that the real magic of life comes when you're giving from living in your purpose. From having discovered that purpose. Mm-hmm. So the audience and I would like to know how it makes you feel to be happily living your life and giving to others through the work you were put on this planet to do and the people all around you have taken notice. So Arnaud, please sit back, open your heart, and have a listen to what people are saying about the impact that you're making on their lives by finding the magic of giving from living in your purpose. One person said his book, The Human Project, fascinates for his humor and creativity. It's a story for those who wish to look at themselves from their hearts and leave their minds to rest for a while. Another says, he opens up a door where everything is possible. Another said, he teaches that coming to love ourselves and remembering that we are not alone or separate in this world is essential for anyone seeking greater fulfillment and joy in their lives. Others said, poetic, powerful, enthusiastic, open-hearted, light-hearted, whimsical, joyful, grateful, comforting, loving, dedicated, inspiring. What a delight. He opens your mind and your soul to looking at life in a new direction. He wants us to embrace our authentic self, connecting with our purpose, and live a life well lived. His poems, which I read slowly and let them marinate a while, has changed the way I see the world. And finally, one person said simply, Arno, in writing The Human Project, you were assisted by higher beings. So Arno, how does all that incredible love make you feel?
Good. Of course.
Isn't it amazing? You know, I've written a few books too. And when you write a book and you tell us how this makes you feel. If you recommend a book that you've read to me and I read it and I say, oh, Arno, that was a great book. Thank you for that recommendation.
Of
or
course.
If I yeah. read your book and I say some of the things like, oh my gosh, you've changed my life. How much different does it feel when I say thank you for reading a book that you recommended versus reading the book that you poured your heart and soul into?
It's definitely not the same, of course. But I guess the most important part is how impactful it has been for you, right? Whether it's me writing it or not doesn't really matter. But at the very least,
correct.
What challenges it has offered to you, for sure.
Yeah. And that feeling, that smile on your face, actually, that's what this show is all about. It's finding that magic in each of our lives. And it's available for each of us. That's what I believe. I know you
yes.
believe it too.
Totally.
And it comes from this great big happy circle. Giving your time, talents, and treasures is a powerful pathway for discovering your purpose. And then giving from living in your purpose brings profound joy to your life, but also to the lives of those around you. So it seems that giving leads to purpose and giving from purpose leads to joy. So to capture the entire exponential power of our happy formula, Arno, I'm going to tweak it just a little bit more. See how this sounds. Power times purpose times giving equals happy to the third power. And that's really, truly, deeply happy. Does that sound about right to you?
Sure. Yeah. I mean, it's definitely a path. There are a thousand paths to the heart, but this is definitely one powerful one.
And I think, thank you for that, but I think the key is that you teach and that I teach is they're all different and they're unique. You
mm-hmm.
need to find your path.
Yeah,
right?
Exactly.
That's the gig.
Exactly. Your every single path is unique and they are absolutely amazing and perfect.
Yeah.
But indeed, are we ready to allow ourselves to live truly ourselves completely? That's the question.
That's the question. I love it. All right, let's wrap things up the lightning round. I love the power of words and the capacity for great quotes to change lives. So I'm going to read a few of my favorites and have you tell us what they mean to you. Give us the first thing that comes to your mind, Arno, because we call this a lightning round. Here we go. From Ramana
Maharshi.
Maharshi. Yeah. By the will of the Creator, the fruits of actions are realized.
Yes. So it calls for every single moment we have the opportunity, whether to, we take our mind and we want to do something, that's one option, or we listen intently to what that moment is arising within us, right? Or following our intuition, it would be another way to say it. And then we serve that impulse to do that, which is a very completely different. And that's what Ramana is talking about here. And when we do that, all of a sudden we live an inspired life. We are following our heart all the way in.
Yeah.
And very quickly, we're going much faster towards our goal than if we are doing it with the will of the mind.
That's what people don't realize. It's actually, it creates an easier life, not an easy life, but all of it is serving purpose. It's like an elite athlete physically exerting themselves to near torture, but they feel complete joy from it.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's not that you don't have exertions and troubles, but it takes on a whole different level, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, totally. Because you're You're in joy and in coherence with the flow of life, with the flow of your life. So it's you're writing your own symphony consciously.
Yeah, love it. Another one from Ramana. He said, eventually, all that one has learned will have to be forgotten.
So it refers to the fact that, so when we are born, we go through our family and all that and schools and whatnot, and we collect mimetisms, but also knowledges, and which are in most cases illusions. They are not, they are projections of some sort coming from other people or ours. And therefore, we're not in connection with our core nature. And it's time to remember our core nature by forgetting all these conditionings that were necessary for a while, but now we can decide if it's still ours or not.
I love that. This one is similar, kind of, and it comes from Billy Joel paraphrasing Socrates. He said, the more I learn, the less I know.
Yes. So it's similar, and then it stays a bit more in the mind, in the sense that the more you learn, the more questions arise, and therefore the less you figure out. Oh, yes. But ideally, you would let go of the need of learning and just be yourself and surrender yourself to that inner wisdom that is already there.
Yes, you don't have to learn it. You already know it.
Exactly.
Yeah, very good. This is from Rumi. I think you mentioned him earlier. And I love this one. He said, if you put your heart against the earth with me in serving every creature, our beloved will enter you from our sacred realm, and we will be so happy.
Yes, so I mean, everything is said there. Yeah, but it calls for this service, I think, you know, to be the vessel that serves our flow of life. In other words, you know, the universe is there to support us and nurture us and guide us towards ourselves. So if we can surrender to that and have the humility to follow that lead, then all of a sudden we're completely taken care of all the time, and that's amazing. So
I think also that Rumi added to that, not just serving others, but serving others shoulder to shoulder together, and
well,
that adds another whole part of it, doesn't it?
I would go beyond that. It's more importantly, it's not serving the others, because the other per se is more of a reflection of me, but it's like letting the others and, you know, reality show me a path and me following it, and that's it, and that's more than enough. I don't need to do a lot of things around that.
Very good. This is from Sarah Young. I just read this recently. I just loved it. She said, living well is both a discipline and an art.
It's both a discipline and a heart.
Art, like art.
It's sure. I'm not sure I understand fully what she says here, but it sounds good.
Well, so I think in your particular work, you explained to us already as part of your routine to stay where you need to be is to continually work on your art. What do you call it? Your heart method.
Yes. Yeah.
Heart. So that's discipline.
That's discipline. Yes, indeed.
And the art part she'd be talking about is you created that concept and you built it, or you allowed it to be built through you. And so that's, you have to steadfastly do the work, and you have to do it in your authentic creative way.
So another way of saying it is you have to walk the talk.
Correct. Very good. And this is from Goth. It's our show anchor. He says, whatever you can do or dream you can do, begin it. Boldness has genius, power, and magic in it. Begin it now.
Well said. Amen.
Amen. All those were smart guys and gals. All right. Thank you, Arno. And now, folks, it's your chance to be a giver, too. If you can hear my voice and you are inspired by today's show with Arno St. Paul, please share a little love with our incredible broadcast team by giving what you can to WYTV7. They're a 501c3 charity on a mission to educate, empower, and encourage. They do good works with your kindness. Arnaud, I love your life purpose to open a billion hearts by guiding others to live through their hearts. And I admire your global social impact project called Give Nation, which we didn't get a chance to talk about, where you're empowering children to take part in crafting a better tomorrow and positively impact the planet with a larger goal of creating a happier, better human existence. And I'm super happy that you've shared your heart-guided, people and planet first entrepreneurial spirit on our show today. Will you please take a minute or two and share any parting remarks you'd like to leave with our audience?
1 minute, that's not enough.
2 minutes, 3 minutes, go my
yeah,
friend.
No. Give me a few hours. What could I share with the audience? One, never forget that life is absolutely perfect in every single way. What may need to be revised is the way we perceive it or our expectation to it. So, but it's always absolutely harmonious and perfect in ways that we cannot even imagine. Second, your life is there to show you the way towards a brighter version of yourself, a bigger one, a more fulfilled one, a more joyful one, a more peaceful one, etc., etc. Listen to it. You deserve it. Because of the fact that you exist on this planet in this moment, you deserve it, just for that fact. So allow it to happen, even if it's in a small way at first. And that's an important part. Play with your reality, with your experience. So allow it for 1 hour, and then maybe after for a day, and then maybe for a month. But stay there, stay in that play mode with gratitude of what is unfolding, etc. With these two keys plus Matt's formulas, you're golden. It's amazing. And from then on, you know, enjoy life to the fullest, to the most. And it's, by the way, it's not a struggle. You don't have to climb the mountain. On the contrary, it's one beautiful slope that will bring you to you. But for that, you have to allow it.
Fantastic. That's a great way to end. Thank you, Arnaud, very much.
And my pleasure. Thank you.
Yeah, and I also want to thank WITV7 for hosting and promoting our show so we can keep interviewing inspiring guest stars like Arnaud and reaching folks just like you, ready to create your own extraordinary lives. And most especially, thank you, viewers and listeners. You'll find links to social media and all things Arnaud St. Paul. Find him, friend him, read his blog about transformational coaching, and buy his books on Amazon. You'll find all the links in the show notes.
And maybe people can join hearteconomy.org, where they can have the assessment and then potentially join one of our cohorts down the road on Heart Chambers.
Very good. Hearteconomy.org. We'll put that in the show notes too. And finally, from me to you, dear friends, I love you and I want you to be really, truly, deeply happy too. So go to happyliving.com right now and download our free mini but mighty ebook called Making Your Mark of Significance. And once you read the book, and it really only takes about 30 minutes or so, then give some thought about what we can do together, you and me, to improve the happy of your world, one person at a time. Till next time, I'm Matt Gersper. You are awesome, and this is the Something Significant Show.